In this episode of Real Chemistry, we're going to continue talking about limiting reactants by doing some practice problems. So remember, the idea in limiting reactants is we want to think about which ingredient in a recipe runs out first, and we also want to think about how much product we can actually make, which is something we call our theoretical yield. So let's take a look at a few more of those problems. So this one says 3 moles of N2 reacts with 7 moles of H2. What is the limiting reactant, and what is the theoretical yield of ammonia in moles? This is what we're running our reaction with, 3 moles of N2 and 7 moles of H2. So that's basically what we have on hand in the chemistry lab that we're going to run this reaction with. And we're going to do this problem in the exact same way. We're going to go from 3 moles of N2 to how much ammonia I can make. And we're going to go from 7 moles of H2 to how much ammonia I can make. And I've broken this process down into 3 steps. Really, the first step is calculate how much product can be made with each reactant, and that's most of the problem. And again, if you're having trouble doing that, go ahead and watch that stoichiometry video. That's where I go through that sort of calculation in detail. What we're adding here is thinking about the product we can make when we consider that we have 2 different ingredients and different amounts of them. All right, so now we're going to calculate how much ammonia we can make, and ammonia is that NH3 guy there at the end. So this is ammonia right here. And again, you can just think through how much product you can make, or you can write a conversion factor. We know we want to get rid of nitrogen, so we're going to write N2 here. And we know we want to get to ammonia, so we're going to write NH3 here. We go up to our recipe, and we see that there's a 2 next to ammonia. So we put a 2 down here. We also see that there's a 1 next to nitrogen. And our chemical recipe just tells us these ratios that our reactants combine in and how much products they form, so we can do these calculations. So 3 times 2 just gives us 6 moles of ammonia. And we're not done yet, right? Because that's just how much we can make with our N2, but we want to know how much we can make with our hydrogen also. And so in this case, we want to get rid of our hydrogen, because that's what we're starting with. And we want to get ammonia. And again, we filled in with our chemical recipe. So we have a 3 in front of H2, and that's what we put in front of H2 here. And we have a 2 in front of ammonia. So if I multiply 7 moles times 2 and divide it by 3, I get 4.7. Now, of course, if I'm taking into account sig figs, I would really round that to 5. So we get 4.7 moles of NH3, which should be round to 5 if this was our final answer for sig figs. All right. So let's go ahead and round that for sig figs, 5 moles in H3. Because we put 1 sig fig in of our 7 moles of nitrogen. And our conversion factors here, it's important to note, are exact numbers. So these guys, this 2 and this 3, have unlimited sig figs because they're just ratio stuff combines and that we know from our chemical reaction. So what's our limiting reactant and what's our theoretical yield? Well, that's where step 2 and 3 come in. Step 2 says the reactant which makes less is limiting. So what makes less, nitrogen or hydrogen? Well, hydrogen gives us a lower quantity of ammonia as our product. And so that means hydrogen is our limiting reactant. So we could write down hydrogen is equal to our limiting reactant. That's what runs out first when we try to run this reaction. Now, how do we know what the theoretical yield is? The theoretical yield is the lower quantity of product. So hydrogen, of course, is not our theoretical yield. We're not making hydrogen. What our theoretical yield is this guy right here, our 5 moles of NH3. So our theoretical yield is 5 moles NH3. So Ty equals 5 moles NH3. So that's how we do these problems when we word them in more chemistry textbook-like ways. We're gonna do one more problem where the conversion that we have to do is just a touch more complicated. So in this problem, we're given our chemical reaction. And we're also told that 4.1 grams of O2 reacts with 0.24 grams of H2. And we want to know, what is the limiting reactant? What's the theoretical yield of water in grams? So in this case, the main difference between our last problem and this problem is now we're given our quantities in grams. So we have grams of O2 and grams of H2. And it also tells us that we want to calculate the theoretical yield of water in grams. So what this is called a mass-to-mass conversion. We're going to go from grams of reactants to grams of products. And this involves a few extra steps. We cover these steps in that video, Introduction to Stoichiometry. And I will go through them again now. So first, we're just going to do the same thing that we've been doing all along. We're going to calculate how much product we can make, in this case in grams, from each reactant. So we're going to start off with our 4.1 grams of O2. And we want to go to grams of water eventually. So way down here, at some point in the future, we're going to get out grams of H2O. And the first thing we want to do when we start with grams is that we need to convert to moles, because our chemical recipe is in terms of moles. Think about this. If I said you had 200 grams of bread, how many sandwiches can you make? Can't figure it out, right? You need to know how big each slice is. And the same way, when I tell you you have 4.1 grams of oxygen, you can't figure out how much product you can make unless you first take that to moles. So that's going to be our first step. We're going to take grams of oxygen to moles of oxygen, and we know that there's 1 mole of oxygen for every 32 grams of oxygen. So 32 grams of O2 is 1 mole. So that takes care of our grams and gets us into moles, right? Our grams are now gone. And so since our grams are now gone, now we can apply a conversion factor that goes between moles of O2 and moles of water. So we want to get rid of O2, right? And we know that eventually down at the end, we want to get out water. And how do we fill in this conversion factor? The same way we have all along from our chemical recipe. Now that we're in moles of oxygen, we can use our chemical recipe to tell us how much H2O we can make from a given amount of oxygen. So 1 oxygen goes in to make 2 moles of H2O. So I put a 2 right here and a 1 right there. And now I'm not quite done, because that would give me moles of O2. Notice the moles that I've written have not been canceled out. And I want to go to grams of water. And here's where it's really important to keep track of what reactant you're dealing with. In this case, we are dealing with water, so we're going to use the molar mass of water to go back to grams of water. So we have moles up here up top. And that means that we want to get rid of that. We're going to write our moles down here. Another way to think about that is that we're in moles from our mole-to-mole conversion, and now we want to go to grams. And our molar mass of water is 18.02 grams. So that's our 3 conversion factors that we're going to need to write to go ahead and calculate grams of water. And if we multiply all of that out, we'll get out 4.6 grams of H2O. So that's how much water I can make with 4.1 grams of oxygen in this chemical reaction. Now we're going to do the same thing with our hydrogen. So we start out with 0.24 grams of H2. And we want to know how many grams of water can we make. First, we're going to get rid of our grams of hydrogen. So we have 1 mole of hydrogen for every 2.02 grams of hydrogen. So our grams cancel out, and we're left with moles. And now we can use our stoichiometric relationships from our chemical recipe. Stoichiometric relationship sounds complicated, but we're just doing the same thing where we look at the ingredients in our recipe, and we know that for every H2 we put in, we get out some water. And we're going to fill both of those in with 2s, because that's what's in front of them in our chemical recipe. And then now what we're in, you'll notice, is moles of water. So we have our moles here and our water here. Our H2 is now canceled out. And the last step, if we want to get to grams of water, is to go ahead and multiply by, once again, our molar mass of water. So we have 18.02 grams for every 1 mole. And when we multiply all of that through, we're going to get out the mass of water we can make from our hydrogen, which turns out to be 2.1 grams. So this is a limiting reactant problem where we go from grams of reactant to grams of product. So that's just step one. We've completed step one. And now we know the reactant which makes less is limiting. Which reactant makes less? Well, my hydrogen, we see, results in 2.1 grams. Meanwhile, my oxygen results in 4.6 grams. And that tells me that my hydrogen is limiting. So my hydrogen is my limiting reactant. What's my theoretical yield? Well, the lower quantity of product is our theoretical yield. So in that case, our 2.1 grams of water is what we could actually make. We'd never get this because our hydrogen runs out. So 2.1 grams of water is our theoretical yield. Okay, so remember, our theoretical yield is just what we get if everything goes perfectly, and our limiting reactant is what runs out first. We've talked about in this video how you can calculate those things. If you have any questions, please ask them below. Please also subscribe to get updates about future videos, or visit my channel to see other videos on chemistry.